Hello, how are you? Now I go to the last introduction or the part of Odelo, and immediately after this class we start our textbook passage. And this class I mean that I will give you a type of a synopsis or a total summary of the story or plot used by Shakespeare here. Before going through line by line, it will take a lot of classes, and listening to the class and watching this class will give you a different experience by which you can develop a Shakespearean inclination towards the dramatic world. So I would recommend you to follow my classes from the beginning to the end so that you along with me can make a good journey towards the end of what really happens in Odelo as such. And the itinerant and constant chasing and the interest in drama or interest in studies would make definitely you a successful student after graduation. And God knows and who knows, somebody of you will become a great eminent professor in future. And after learning Shakespeare, that day is over, once you become a professor or a lecturer, you would tell these things to your students, what you experienced from the classes in St. Joseph. So my dear students, you should keep an interest towards drama. You should keep an interest and emotional spirit that would make you to travel through all the dramas of Shakespeare. And nothing impossible in the world if you try. You might have heard about one great eminent philosopher and a great businessman who is known as Michael Jordan. Have you ever come across Michael Jordan? So many companies now possessed by him. Now, he was an average student, Michael Jordan. He was born in a very middle class family. But immediately after his school education, he wanted to learn more practical side of basketball game. And he went to the basketball ground every day early morning. And the father was a small businessman. He was not really interested in that. And the mother also did not give pay attention to him. But once 4 o'clock in the morning, he used to go to the basketball ground and start his train himself. And after 7 days in the biography, this Michael Jordan says in his biography, nobody was over there in the ground during the time, and he had much time to practice himself. And he would put the balls very easily in the goalpost. And he would appreciate himself. And slowly people will come. And by 10 o'clock, all people again will be going home, and he will be left alone on the basketball ground. And he was training himself. It was his constant and continuous training he took himself. And he became later, what do you know? This time father got angry. Now he is not paying attention to the family matters. Father once, it is written in the biography, father called him once, Benjamin or Michael Jordan, come here. You nowadays going in a different way, not responsible in the house. Then what you should do? I'll give you an item, what is called a t-shirt. It is written in the biography, a t-shirt. A plain t-shirt was handed over to him. and asked him, it is reported, you go to the market, you sell it somewhere, someone, get $20. Then he was wondered how, make him a salesman with a small t-shirt. Again, no other way, he went to the market and asked each and everyone, anybody wants a t-shirt like that? But later, once he reached in a particular corner of the street, somebody asked him, what is the price of this? He told $30. All of a sudden, he was in need of, and he bought this and money handed over. He came to father and told, it is reported, you told me $20, I sold it for $30. Now you take this money. The following day also it is written, Michael's father called him, given another t-shirt and asked him to sell it for $100. And he was thinking how to sell it. And now he went to how to sell it for $100. It was a quite impossible amount. So he went to a tattoo workshop, and by his intelligence, he put a Mickey Mouse photograph on a t-shirt, plain t-shirt. And he brought it to, and he was standing in front of a nursery school showing this. And children coming with the parents with a different carrier began to cry. One wanted, another wanted like that, because Mickey Mouse photograph was given. Out of argumentative competition, he gave it for $100, $150. He was very happy. Then he took this money and went to father and handed over. Following day also, father gave him another plain t-shirt. He told, yesterday you gave very much good money. Now you try and sell it for $100, $200. How this is possible? Michael reporting in the biography asking, how is it possible? Everywhere in the shop it is cheap. All t-shirts are having cheap quality and cheap money. How can I sell it for $200? That I don't know. It is depend on your intelligence work. Then what he was thinking and thinking and thinking, Michael went where? Once he went to a regional theater of the town where the famous heroine of Hollywood cinema was attending a function. After the function, Hollywood heroine Francoine Smart is like an Elizabeth Taylor, earlier heroine of Hollywood pictures. He wanted an autograph from this heroine on this t-shirt. And she reluctantly gave autograph on the t-shirt. Immediately after, he went to the public and was ready to sell this t-shirt because it was autographed by a very famous heroine of Hollywood cinemas. And people was very struggling to buy it. And one rich man bought this t-shirt for $1,000. It was the history written by Michael Jordan. Look here, his father was happy. Later, father told Michael, now I understood you have a passion for something. And if you keep this passion, one day or another day, you will become successful. Later, what we see in Michael Jordan's life, still is not dead. Michael Jordan now became a greatest player in basketball in international level. Not merely that, he was the owner of a lot of companies, and also Jordan Airways is under his control. He possessed Jordan Airways. Now seems to be a great, opulent and rich man in the world. What is it to show, my dears? If you chase and chase and chase constantly for one thing, one day or another day, you will become successful. It shows like that. Some people say Othello will be difficult. Some people say Shakespeare will be difficult. Nothing to worry. Chase continuously, constantly. One day or another day, you will be successful. coming to the story of Udalum, we have to introduce these type of characters which are very popular in the story. First character, our heroine Desdemona. To talk about Desdemona, Desdemona is like all other heroines of Shakespearean dramas. She was a very innocent character. She was a very lovely character. She was tenderly as a human being to be loved and infatuated by anybody. Such innocent girls are there plenty. In your own classes also we have so many innocent girls. They know only day and night. Like that, Desdemona is a good angel presented here. From the beginning to the end till her death, was present to the public for a very, very, very human appearance. Once Desdemona appears on the stage, nobody would attend any other characters on the stage. Such a fragrance and such an illumination she would radiate or electrocute on the stage. Such a dynamic character. She is now in the prime of her stage of marriage. Once her father Brabantio, he is a senator in the Venice under the Duke, and he is controlling so many lieutenants and all that. And this Odello, our character Odello, the Moor of Venice, and Desdemona with her father living in Venice. Where this Moor of Venice, he is a stubborn character of almost 6 to 7 feet height, with a very big muscular shoulder, coming almost every day to our Brabantio's house, telling lot of adventurous stories, how he participated in the different battles, how he killed so many valiant heroes, enemies. Unknowingly or knowingly, Desdemona was listening this. This man's very adventurous stories might have influenced Desdemona. This innocent girl, Desdemona, fell in love with him. That was the course of tragedy begins here. He was a type of a blackish moor. This is a white, innocent-like, angel-like Desdemona of a high noble family. Came to in, fell in love with this man, which they kept secretly for some time. But when the story begins, what happens? Roderigo and other people coming and reporting Brabantio. Roderigo, who had an eye on Desdemona from the beginning, was supported by Iago in future. But Roderigo reporting Brabantio, Desdemona's father, that your daughter is lost. Or went and married in the registration office and went to live with Odello, which would make, or which was a very big, what do you call, Himalayan outburst in the heart of Brabantio without his knowledge. His own lonely child till her this age was brought up. Like the modern society, as I referred, so many girls are there without permission of parents and blessings of parents, all of a sudden infatuated to a boy going somewhere to live. It would create a very big breakage in the mind of parents. In the way, Brabantio was totally worried. What happened? Now some people with Iago is always there. He is also an officer in charge. He was there. He was prompting Brabantio to go and complain to the Duke. And another Duke's seen coming there, where Odello and Desdemona were presented. This is the story goes in this way. And what happened? Another one person is there, Cassio. This Cassio, not Cassius, Cassio, All right, this is Cassio. Another character is Cassio. This Cassio, who had been made lieutenant as an officer under Othello, and Iago was against Cassio because both are in the same cadre of rank. But fortunately, this Cassio got to promotion by the influence of Othello, which was really apt for Iago. From that moment, Iago planned to do something because this Cassio to be taught a lesson and Othello to be given a lesson. So it was actually Iago thought it was a real rank and position to be given to him, or it is better to say he was the better claimant for the post, but Cassio was promoted as a lieutenant. Later, what happens? Iago decided as a malignant enemy in the story, a anti-hero in the story, he decided to teach everybody a lesson. Cassio to be given a lesson, Othello to be given a lesson, Desdemona to be given a lesson. So he planned everything and made so many tricks and techniques to create this tragedy as the best one in the world. Now what happened? Rodrigo was an officer there. He was also given promise by Iago to have Desdemona in future, was bribed by him. And Iago, the Moor of Othello, later the Moor of Othello, the Moor of Venice, was immediately sent to Cyprus. Cyprus is the neighboring place, was controlled under the Venice Duke. Duke says, Turkish people are coming to Cyprus. So Othello, with your lieutenant Cassius and other people, go and protect Turk from Cyprus from Turkish people. Turkish people are going to attack. So immediately after the third scene, people along with Othello, Desdemona, all other people, with Brabantio's permission also, they go to Cyprus. Now from the second act, only Cyprus is seen till the end. The story goes like that. So, on the one hand, Venice is seen, on the other hand, Cyprus is seen. Once they reach Cyprus, now there was an incarnation of Othello as a very noble man in the palace. And even after their marriage, Desdemona was happy there. She was attended by Emilia, by Iago's wife, also as an attendant. Iago, Rodrigo also coming there. During this time, there was a very big banquet party or liquor party. On this, some problems are created by some people. Then Cassio was one among them. Now this time was propitious for Iago. Iago telling Othello, this your lieutenant Cassio was a drunkard. Cassio should possess a good quality of a lieutenant. And it was the first time he gave a lesson to Cassio. Othello, out of his temper, dismissed him from lieutenant post. Look here, the malignance and clear thing that what played by Iago during this story. He was a man of what you call poisoning. He was a man of prompting that person to do something. Othello, who thought Iago was very confident, Othello, who thought Iago will be trustworthy, he had so many other plans to teach this Othello a lesson. Who promoted Cassius a lieutenant, and Cassio, who is a lieutenant, should be demoted from his post. Iago planned. What did Iago plan? What did Iago feel? What he got? Othello immediately dismissed Cassio from the lieutenant post. Now what happened? The same Iago going to Cassio and telling him, what a stupid person you are here. You go and approach our Desdemona, who is a very innocent noble queen of our noble duchess of our land. Once you appeal her, she would tell Othello to promote you in the same post. Look, malignant cunning story done by Iago. Now Cassio believed or trusted our Iago, and now slowly approaching Desdemona, appealing Desdemona. This is our first meeting. Please tell your husband to give me the lost post, lieutenant post. It was not my mistake, but other people made a mistake, and I did not drink too much. But only I made to make peaceful with them. So Desdemona also agreed. Okay, I would tell my husband to promote you once again. It was not a plan by Iago. These people did not think. During this time, Desdemona telling Othello, very good word, please listen me, Lord. Please promote him or give lieutenant post to Cassio once again. Othello did not think anything, but later stage, Iago tells Othello, what? Your wife is having some bad relation with Cassio. That would made Othello wonder. This may be the reason she is constantly requesting me to make him lieutenant. But no, as far as readers and listeners and spectators, you should think it was a cunning experiment done by Iago, by which Othello was also made very jealousy out of Cassio and suspicious on his wife. So that stage slowly goes. Later stage, what happens? Desdemona was given a handkerchief by Othello at the primary site of your love. That handkerchief had a history. That handkerchief was given by his mother, telling that it should not be lost in his life, because his mother was presented this handkerchief by her husband, Othello's father. So by hereditary, this handkerchief has a lot of values. This handkerchief, Othello presenting Desdemona. But in another later stage, once Othello gets a headache, she gave this handkerchief unknowingly from her pocket. But Othello takes it and throws it away, unnoticing it. But both of them went into their bedroom. This time, Emilia took this Desdemona's precious and valuable handkerchief, handed over to Iago, her husband, who was a very cunning man. What did he do? He took this handkerchief and put it in Cassio's bedroom. And later on stage, Othello was told by Iago that your valuable, precious handkerchief given to your wife, which was a hereditary handkerchief, but I saw it in Cassio's bedroom. How is it possible? Iago asking. Slowly, development of thought going towards the end of the drama. Plenty things happening. Cassio quarrels with Roderigo in order to not able to kill. That moment, Iago comes and kills Roderigo. Roderigo goes. This time it is reported to the Duke Othello. When the other people coming to Othello's palace, another thing, out of suspicion, jealousy, Othello, what did he do? He enstrangled her wife, or Desdemona, on the bed out of. Then it was really, it is written almost 50,000 books, critical books on Othello. In one of the books, it is written, Alexander Marshall as a character, who did almost 10,000 stage scene in the bedroom. It is written actually, not in the cinema like. Dramas in the Globe Theatre would be practiced and shown at least 3 or 2 times every day. And Othello was a drama has been exhibited in this Globe Theatre for 2-3 years continuously. After this practice, after this 3 years drama, this Marshall went to his house, live with wife and children for 2 months. The end of 2 months, what happened? He unknowingly strangled his own real wife on the bed, because he was thinking that killing Desdemona is just like practicing his life cannot be forgotten. Unknowingly, he strangled his own wife on the bed, it is reported. So such basic real experiments were done by the characters in the drama. So later stage, what happened? Iago is arrested and Cassio is given charge of Cyprus, and later this story going. So now you can understand, as people call, this is a tragedy of handkerchief. This is a tragedy of true love. This is a tragedy of jealousy. This is a tragedy of doubtfulness. This is a tragedy of cheating. Lot of people going, but these characters easily cannot be forgotten from our memory. Till that moment, we will come to the textbook as such. You bring the textbook, we will start. Why desperate Brabantio presented first stage, and how this Desdemona as a lonely child report father that the way my mother, your wife loved you, the way your daughter me should love my husband, father, no other way but I should go with him, this blackish Moor of Venice, I will live with him, please. Very reluctantly, Brabantio allows, and in the later stages, lot of things happening. What all these happenings and what all the real wordings of Shakespeare? Now let us wait. Now you come to the stage. Let us see the first scene. What is going to happen till that moment? Goodbye.